And now, dear children, here is our story.
So there was this very talented composer in Russia named Sergei Prokofiev, and he loved to write music for orchestras. There was also a woman named Natalia Sots, who was the director of the Moscow Musical Theater for Children, and she came to Sergei and said, "I want you to write a musical symphony for children." And Sergei was like, "Okay." And the reason Natalia wanted to do this was because she wanted to introduce children to the different types of instruments and musical sections that we find in a classic orchestra. And these four main sections are the string section, the woodwind section, the brass section, and the percussion section. There are amazing recordings of different orchestras all across the internet. So a great thing to do if you want to familiarize yourself with the different sections of the orchestra is to look up some of these different symphonies on YouTube. This is a performance from the 2017 Gateways Music Festival of Sergei Rachmaninoff's Piano Concerto No. 2 in C minor. The pianist you see here is Stuart Goodyear, and the orchestra is being conducted by Michael Morgan. The string section is made up of instruments that make their sound from vibrating strings, and these include instruments like the violin, the viola, the cello, and the double bass. Then the woodwind section is made up of instruments that generate their sound from air blown across a reed or fiddle. A fiddle is that little hole in a flute that you blow across, and these include instruments like a flute, an oboe, a clarinet, and a bassoon. We can't forget our brass section. This section is made up of instruments where the sound comes through vibrations made with a tube-like mouthpiece and the player's lips. And this includes instruments like the trumpet, the French horn, the trombone, the euphonium, and the tuba. And last but not least, we have the percussion section, which includes all instruments where the sound is made by the striking, beating, or scraping action against the instrument. And this includes classic instruments like the snare drum, the timpani, the bass drum, cymbals, the triangle, and the tambourine. And so Sergei starts thinking, how can I help children learn about different instruments? And then he gets an idea. He thinks, what if we take every instrument in the orchestra and we make it a character in a story? The clarinet could be a cat, and the French horn could be a wolf, and the violin could be a little boy named Peter. And he tells Natalia his idea, and she goes, "That sounds great." So Sergei starts writing his piece. In it, there's a little boy named Peter, who's played by the violin. He has a grandfather who's played by the bassoon. There's a wolf who's played by the French horn. A little bird that's played by a flute. A duck that's represented by the oboe. A cat that's played by the clarinet. And a group of hunters who are portrayed by the timpani. In 1936, Sergei finishes his piece and Peter and the Wolf debuts in Russia. 10 years later, in 1946, Walt Disney creates the now famous animated version of Peter and the Wolf. The Disney animation varies a little bit from the original narrative, but the general gist is the same. Peter wants to go out into the forest, but Grandfather tells him it's not safe. Still, Peter sneaks out, and with his little woodland creature friends, he goes out into the forest anyway. But the forest is dangerous because there's a wolf out there who wants to eat Peter and all of his friends. To find out what happens, you can watch a version of this animation on YouTube that's narrated by David Bowie, or you can listen to different recordings of Peter and the Wolf that are narrated all across the internet. After you familiarize yourself with the characters and instruments in Peter and the Wolf, then we'll encourage you to print out a copy of our concentration card game so you can better learn how these different characters and instruments correspond to each other. Here I'm getting set up to print out and make my own set of concentration cards. I have my hand out here, and you can see that all of the characters correspond to an instrument. And here's what they should look like once you cut them out, just simple little rectangles. You can, if you want, take some color pencils and color them in to add a little extra pizzazz to your card deck. Anyway, as you can see, when you flip these cards over, they're a little bit translucent, so we can kind of see through them. And we don't want to cheat at our card game. So what we're going to do is just take some cardstock, and I'm actually just using a manila folder, and we're going to cut out some rectangles to paste our pieces of paper onto. Now, these rectangles are about 3 3/4 inches by about 2 1/2 inches. And I just made a big grid of rectangles this size. And if you need help, just ask an adult to help you trace this grid out. Then you're gonna cut out your rectangles and either make sure you're asking an adult to help you with this or have an adult around to at least supervise. Once you have them cut out, you're going to take your glue stick and you're going to paste your little cutout rectangle cards onto the cardstock. And now we won't be able to see through the other side when we play our card game. And once we have all of our cards cut out and pasted to our cardstock, they look like this. We should have 14 of them, and each character corresponds to an instrument. So take some time to reinforce those connections before you play your game of concentration. So shuffle up your cards, make sure they're nice and mixed together, and then we can start playing. So my cards are flipped over and I'm ready to start making some matches. I picked up the flute. Let's see if I can get the bird. Nope, it's the pair of hunters, so that's not a match. What if I try this card? It's a French horn, and we know that matches with the wolf, but that's grandfather, and he's the bassoon, so that's wrong too. That's the songbird. I know that matches with the flute, and I saw the flute earlier. I think it was here. And that's right, so that's a match. And in case you forget, you can look in the upper corner of the cards and the numbers will let you know as a clue if you have the right pair. So that's the clarinet. Nope, that's a timpani. So instruments don't match instruments. But I know I saw the hunters earlier and that's a match. So there I go. Let's try this card. That's the cat. And the cat goes with the clarinet. All right, I'm doing pretty well. Let's try this card. That's Peter, and he's the violin, obviously. But I haven't seen the violin. That's the oboe. Nope, not a match. Bassoon, that's grandfather. We saw grandfather earlier. I'm pretty sure it was this one. And that's right, so that's another pair. Getting close to finishing. Let's see. Okay, this is the wolf. That's the French horn. I'm pretty sure it was there. That's right. And the oboe is the duck. I haven't seen the duck yet. Is that the duck? Is it that one? Is it this? I don't know. It's the violin. Okay, that's wrong. This was Peter, though, and Peter's the violin. So that's a match. And so this Must be the duck. All right, I finished my game of concentration. I hope you enjoyed learning more about the history of Peter and the Wolf and learned a little bit more about some of the important instruments in a classical orchestra. Hopefully, you'll take some time to listen to a recording of Peter and the Wolf all the way through and be inspired by all the different stories we can tell through music.